Hey, what's up, everybody? It's me, Abdul. I got a message from a viewer, and he wanted to basically know how I go about adding my spotlight effect to my white background images. And I just wanted to do a quick video showing you all how I do it. It's actually an easy process, and it's not hard at all. First thing you need to do, though, is make sure you have a image with a nice white background. I'm actually going to use an image that I took of my nephew. like I said, the process is really simple. First thing you want to do is open your picture up. I've already edited this one and got it to how I want it to look. You're just going to go to your background layer, you're going to create a copy, and you want to throw away the original image, the original background. So now you have a background copy. Then you're going to go to create a new layer, and you're going to move the background copy to the top. Alright, so now you're gonna turn off the background copy so you just have a transparent image. And you're gonna go grab your gradient tool, and you wanna make sure that the radial gradient is selected. You want it to dither, you want transparency. So what I normally do is zoom out and I start drawing my gradient where I think the subject's face is going to be. And honestly, you don't have to turn off the other layer. You can actually do this with the other layer on, but I just prefer to do it with it off. So you're just going to go ahead and draw your gradient. It's going to take a little while. So now you can see you have a little spotlight on your picture. So what you can do now is you can just play around with it. Go to your free transform and just stretch out the canvas so that the spotlight is a little bit more even. Hit enter. Now you can turn back on your original image, and you want to select multiply, and there you go. And that's pretty much how I do it. You can actually play around with some of the other modes if you want to. I prefer the multiply. That's just my preference. Yeah, just play around with it until you get what you want. You can still play around with the layer a little bit. If you want to stretch it out some more so that it's more of a spotlight in the middle. You don't even have to do that, really. And then you can zoom in. Make sure it's what you want. I think that looks pretty good. And also what helps is you can see the lighting around his face. It's really there's a spotlight right here on his forehead. That's because I use a beauty dish, and beauty dish actually creates its own natural spotlight around your subject, but it doesn't really show up when you use a white background. If this was a black background or a gray background, you would see a natural spotlight. So it already has a spotlight effect on the skin. So if you're not using a beauty dish, or if you're not using a light that puts a spotlight on the skin naturally, it's probably going to look kind of odd when you add in the gradient. But I mean, it's up to you whether you want to use it or not. Obviously, when you're done with all that, you're going to go to flatten image. And there you go. You can save it. And that's pretty much the technique. You can use it with Like I said, any white background image that you have. I prefer to use them on images with the full body in the picture. I think it would look kind of odd if I used it on a picture with only the upper body in focus like this. Like, I'm not sure it would look that great on a picture like this, but it's up to you. And then one thing I didn't show you was that you can actually change, play around with the colors once you get the gradient on there. I'm just going to do it again really fast just to show you how easy it is. So you're going to go ahead and duplicate that layer, throw away the background layer. Sorry about that. You're going to add a new layer, that one on top, turn that one off. Your gradient tool already selected. Draw your line from the middle down. And I'm actually drawing an equal distance. I'm not stopping at the edge of the photo. You actually keep going down here. It's kind of weird to describe, but it looks like I'm stopping when where the photo ends, but I'm actually drawing down further down. So now you're gonna go back to your other image, turn on the overlay. Oops, wrong image. Turn on the multiply. Why isn't that working? There we go. You wanna make sure that layer's on top. So now you can actually go to when this layer is selected, you can go to image, adjustments, saturation, and you can change the hue and the saturation of the image. So this is good in case you just want to play around with a bunch of colors and see what they look like. You could change the darkness and the lightness, whatever. Really cool process, really easy. Another option, if you don't want to do this in Photoshop, you can use colored gels on your light source and do it that way. Personally, I don't like to use colored gels because they color the whole image. They don't put a spotlight on the image like this effect does in Photoshop, so that's a drawback, but it's up to you. So that's the quick video, and hope you all learned something, and hope you enjoyed the video. Leave me a comment if you have any questions. Peace.